Hey guys, if you want to upgrade your Merlin firmware software, then you need to follow certain steps. In step 1, you need to download customized Merlin firmware files for your Tevatarantula from the link provided below in the video. You cannot directly use the Merlin firmware files downloaded from the Merlin website. You need to make some necessary changes for your 3D printer. And for Tevatarantula, I had already made those changes and I had uploaded those files to the link provided below in the video. What you have to do is, you have to click on the link provided below in the video. At the instant you will click on the link provided, you will direct it to this page. This is my blog page. Here I had uploaded the firmware files. When you come to the bottom of this blog page, here you can see that I had uploaded the firmware 1.1.9 version files. Click on this link. After clicking this link, you will be directed to a Dropbox page, from where you can download the firmware files. To download, just click on the direct download button. When you click on the direct download button, your firmware files will start downloading. When it gets downloaded, simply go to the files and copy and paste those files to your desktop. So here you can see that I had copy and pasted the downloaded files to my desktop. What I will do next is, I have to, since it is a compressed file, so I need to extract these files. So I will right click and extract the files. Here you can see I had extracted all the files of this folder. So this is my file that contains all the Merlin firmware files and firmware files. Now go to the second step. In second step, you need to download Arduino software that you can download from the website www.arduino.cc. Here you can see that I had already opened the Arduino site, that is www.arduino.cc. Go to the software section and click on the downloads button. At the instant you will click on the download button, you will direct it to a new page, where you will, at the bottom you will find a Windows installer. Since I am using Windows, so I am clicking on Windows installer. After clicking Windows installer, a new page will come where you will ask to donate some money. If you want to donate some money to this open source community, then you can do that. Otherwise, just click on just download. At the instant I clicked at just download, my downloading has started. Here you can see my Arduino software is getting downloaded. Wait for a couple of minutes. So friends, you can see that my Arduino software has been downloaded. Now what I will do is, I will install it. Just double click on this downloaded software. At the instant you will click, you will ask option that, are you agree with all the terms and conditions of the software. So I will click on this, I agree. I will click on next, install. So you can see that my Arduino software is getting installed. So here you can see that my Arduino software has been installed and the installation has been completed. So I will click on this close option. And on the desktop, I can see that shortcut has been created of the installed software. So I am done with the two steps. First, to download the Merlin firmware file. Second, to install the Arduino software. Now the third step. In third step, I need to connect my computer with the 3D printer motherboard using USB cable. Now I will connect one end of the USB cable to my computer. And other end of my USB cable to my 3D printer motherboard. As soon as I plug my USB cable to my 3D printer motherboard, you can see there is a light blinking here. This means my USB cable is connected to my 3D printer as well as my computer. So friends, as we had connected our 3D printer motherboard with our computer via USB cable, so our next step is to flash new Merlin firmware version using Arduino software. To do so, what we have to do is, go to the folder of the Merlin firmware version that we had downloaded earlier. Open that folder. In that folder, go to the Merlin folder. Here you will find lots of folder where you will find the Merlin folder. Inside Merlin folder, go to downward. At the downward, you will get a file named Merlin with, and its file type is Arduino file. So what you have to do is double click on that file. When you double click on that file, it will start opening through the Arduino software. So wait for that to open it. When it will done opening, you can see that there is lots of icons, and this is the home page of the Arduino software and the file that you had opened. So what you have to do next is you have to check that the firmware you had downloaded is correct or not. To do so, simply just click on this verify tick option. By clicking this, your software will verify that the program that is written in this firmware are all correct. So here you can see that I had done compiling my program and it's all okay without any error. So what you have to do next is you have to connect your 3D printer motherboard with this Arduino software. To do so, go to the tools option and here you will find the port that is connected to your 3D printer. In the port section, simply select the port here. And the next, you have to select the board type. To do so, again go to the tool section and in the board option, you have to select the Arduino Genuino Mega or Mega 2560. Simply click on that. So you are now ready to flash your 3D printer firmware. Now go to this upload button and click on that. At the instant you will click on it, this button, your 3D printer motherboard will start flashing and your new firmware will start uploading to your 3D printer motherboard. So let's get started. At the instant you will click on this upload button, your program will again compile and start uploading to your 3D printer motherboard. Now you can see that your program is first compiling and then it will upload to your motherboard. Now you can see that it's uploading. Also you will find that in your 3D printer motherboard there will be two lights that is continuous blinking. So now you can see that we are done with the uploading of firmware. So now you can unplug your USB cable through your 3D printer motherboard and you can enjoy 3D printing. So guys, if you liked my videos, please hit like button and subscribe. Also, one more thing that I want to add in this video is after upgrading this Merlin firmware latest version, you will be able to see a new feature in your 3D printer, that is the resume feature. If in case of a power loss, you can resume your 3D prints. That is the most advantageous feature added to this latest Merlin firmware. So thank you guys. Thanks for watching. See you.